it's a big school of them, biggest school of them. I'm looking at the biggest money.
That's tea, of course.
You know, like, the travelling part of it's good, but it's what you get up to. That's where it's at.
Can I get them both? No, one's chasing the other one. Oh, right in the shallows. They were like an ankle deep water.
This year's gonna be something else.
Caddy?
Yep.
We'll keep him for the pot.
Thank you.
Mr. Besser.
Give it him, Jackson.
Got away.
This little bugger, he can fish.
Oh, that's him, LJ, Lurick Jr. Caddy? Oh, come off. Throw him back, mate, you'll get him. Fast, fast. Oh, he's heavy, might have crab in him. Very heavy, eh?
Jackie, look, LJ's pulling in the crab pot.
Keep going, keep going. You got him.
Use
your muscles. Oh, yes, look at that. You got a crab. He's a big one. Look at the size of that. He's a monster!
Yeah!
Hey, look at that! Oh, one little one. We'll throw the little one back. Rightio, let's see how we take him out. Look at the beauty. Look at that. He's probably the biggest bugger.
He is a big boy.
All right, look out, boys.
I'm the little one.
Billy. There we go. Look out. Here he comes.
Hey! Oh, what a monster.
Oh! Size. Hey, what a beauty.
That is a noise. That is the biggest by far.
He's a beauty. Down below. Too slow. Jackson.
Ah, there she is.
She's gone.
Where's he gone?
That hit it hard.
Oh, black tip. Fuck. Reef shark. Over to the...
And cows don't know how lucky they are. Just like that, we're back on our own again. Anyone would think that is daylight. What a moon. She's quiet out there. Not a soul in sight. So, following day, no idea, but later on, we were lucky enough to have another morning glory on my bunta coming through. So I want to show you, we didn't cop the full of it because it broke up, but turn the wind noise down if you want, but I want to show you what it's like when they actually come through. They come through with a lot of wind. Just like that, she's back to normal. And looking like a fine day. That's the rangers going along the coastline, keeping an eye on how the seagrass is going.
something that happened to me back in about 2014 it was, over in the NT, which blew me out of the water. It comes so close to camp, is happening now 10 years later, and it's happening right in front of camp. I'm leaving a bee for now. I'm waiting until she gets more comfortable, and then I'll go over and I'll show you. Now, this is pretty out there. Murrandoo was only just saying the other day that when they were sitting underneath the trees, they had the same thing happen to them right in front of them. That was only a week ago, like when he was here last, not long ago at all. And now it's fucking happening to me. What an experience. I'm still pinching myself. Dodge actually spotted her before I did. I was up in the back scrub. We both come out, ears pricked up, looked straight at the beach, started barking. I'm thinking another pelican. I looked down and here she is coming up over that horizon. And I went back and looked because I'm thinking that is awfully close. Like, it was actually 2015, so about 9 years ago, and it was around July the 15th, back over in the NT, that last happened to me. And you think, I took off in 2008, living like this, and I've camped a lot on beaches, and in that whole time, that's happened to me twice. I shouldn't say only, like, that wouldn't happen to a lot of people at all, no matter how long they travel for, but, oh. I don't know if it's a shark or a salmon or a barra or what. Something's going along the coast. Not too far out, and I turn away for 5 seconds and now I can't see a thing. There it is. Oh, there's a couple of them. Or is that, I think it is. So I'm gonna it's coming back. It is coming. It's going to hammer it. I think it's a bluey. Are we going to get a... Oh, it's after it. I think it's got it. Does too. Going to let him swim away. Got him. Hooked him. Oh, it's a shark, I think. Oh, I don't know. Oh, it is. Damn. Very good to be true. Not to worry. There we go. At least I wasn't seeing things. Feels surreal. We're all packed up, but come quicker than I thought. But got to head in now. So it's been 3 or 4 weeks or so. So time has come. I've actually got more, and you would have seen him from one of the first episodes. And they're going to help me. I'm going to follow him back out. So it is a long hike. It's going to be a long hike. It's just a bit tracky and weavy the first section. I'll faintly remember it, but instead of stuffing around, I'm so glad that, yeah, I get to follow them back out. And then once I hit the main road, should be right. But we do have a bit of a drive. Max tracks are out because I have a feeling it's a bit sandy getting out of here. So it's going to be a long night. And I don't think I'll be filming much after this. I'm going to be stuffed. Anyway, we're going to get off this beach. I'm going to sit up the back and give them a holler over the UHF, and we'll see yous when I see yous. Cheers for this, eh?
Nah,
he's trying to find main way out.
Yeah, nah, all good, brother.
Yeah, quick, clear to hello. The front.
Welcome, Dale.
Coming to the back.
Yep.
Welcome,
my brother.
Did you end up getting any crabs?
Oh, brother, too much.
Yeah, good
too
stuff.
Too much. I was just having a good feed there.
Yeah, so
we're taking time.
Ah, the camp man.
Camp.
The camp. I've got 5 videos already.
Okay.
So, and they start Tomorrow.
Yeah,
Monday, yeah, tomorrow. There you go. Oh, then I'll follow you through. I'm probably going to be slow though, brother, eh?
Nah, well, you follow me, you'll be right.
Yeah, I'll just,
I'm going back up this way.
Yeah.
But, you should, follow me back up this road here again.
Yeah. So I think that was the, in one of their other videos now. Yeah. Or was that at Murrandoo?
Yeah, I think.
Out on the Albert.
Yeah.
So I've got a few of them that have done that too, so. Oh, so I've just come out of the truck after a long drive and I run into a couple of fellas working on the council from Doomadgee, and they kind of like watching my videos.
Welcome to the Gulf of Carpentaria, mate.
That's the way.
Take some more barrels. Have a good one.
Oh, geez, guys. Oh, you can't get any better than this. These guys are showing me where the local bakery is in town. I am killing for something. Oh, that's us. Cheers to the guys that are dropping us off at the bakery, and good on to the fellas at the bakery as well. What a top little spot. If you're coming through Doomadgee, I suggest you stop in there. I just got me a pie and some chips and an iced coffee. Let's go.
What an experience it was to be out there, Gunnamulla. That definitely is by far the most remotest and isolated beach camp I've ever done. That's been on mainland, obviously. The shit hits the fan. It's not like driving in or out, it'll be chopper, you know what I mean? Like when you're out there, it is something else. Yeah. I don't know how to explain it, but yeah, I really want to thank the Gung leader people for letting me go up there, you know, for inviting me up there. And a special thanks to the brother Murrandoo Yanner. Now, we met a few years back now, and you know, kept in contact and stuff like that, and he always told me about this spot, and I thought, the way I travel, you know, I never know where I'm going to be, I don't know where I'm going to end up, and well, happened to be the opportunity popped up and it happened, you know. You just can't put a time on something, I don't think. You know, if I was to plan it, it wouldn't happen like that, I don't reckon, but it's how it happened, and it wasn't planned, and it just fell into place. I want to thank you, bro, I really do. That was the stuff you've taught me out there, you know, I couldn't learn that in a book or anything like that, or watching a YouTube video myself. That was something else to actually learn it right then and there. So, and to be able to, you know, make the videos about it and stuff like that, that was even better, because I can use that myself, because as much as I remember, I forget an awful lot. So to be let me like record you in video, at least now I can always go back and watch that video and think, that's right. And another thanks to Moira and the fellas for helping me get out. Obviously, you know, I would have been up Shit's Creek without a paddle without yous. I really would have. But but cheers, and it's good to meet you guys. And hopefully next time I'm up that way, we'll catch up. I'll definitely let yous know next time I come through Doomadgee, that's for sure. Well then, guys, I hope yous enjoyed that little episode, that little series and that. But now, fortunately, we're kind of back to reality, I guess, whatever you'd call it. That is just so different up there, it really was. You know, it was just, everything. Every good thing you can think about in each spot you go to, just picture all them good things rolled up into one. That's what it was like up at that spot. Again, cheers, brother. Anyway, guys, back at it. So I'll see yous next Monday. Catch yous, eh?